it. Let's do it. You know what's crazy?
I'll train you. Can I train you?
Let's do it.
Hey, let's do it. I'll train you.
David's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters, right? You agree?
I agree, man.
Okay.
I have to agree with that.
ESPN made a list of their pound-for-pound. First of all, they had Crawford won, which I think Canelo's won, but okay. But they didn't have him, they didn't have Charlo, they didn't have Pacquiao. And Max Kellerman said, yeah, maybe we have some bias because they're ESPN guys. So half of the list is ESPN fighters. So why don't you call it ESPN fighters pound-for-pound, not boxing pound-for-pound?
Exactly, that's what it is, and that's what, I mean, you see that happen every day with them. Of course, they're not going to get other fighters. They're going to try to promote their own fighters that they have in their network, you know?
But it's not a real,
it's understandable, yeah. You know what I mean? We just got to continue working hard and show the people where we're at, and little by little, you know, we'll get that recognition.
Hopefully. Well, I mean, David's already there. Just this fight coming up, March 13th, and then afterwards, the sky's the limit.
Exactly. Just gonna continue to stay focused.
Ron Ellis is he's been sparring Canelo a lot.
Yeah, I watched some of his videos. He only has one loss. Yeah. I think he's very strong, you know, very slick. He's a really good fighter. Like I said, he only has one loss, so he's up there. And we just gotta continue to stay busy until big opportunities come.
He used to train with Robert.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
Yeah, I knew that. Yeah. I was looking at through his videos and I saw it. He was training here, so you know, like at the end of the day, you know, it's work. We gotta work hard and look good for the fight in order to keep progressing and try to get to a bigger fight.
If Manny Pacquiao fights Errol Spence, what do you think?
Ah, that's another good fight, Errol Spence and Manny Pacquiao. Man, that's really tough. To me, you know, I will have to go a little bit with Errol Spence, but Manny Pacquiao could, you know.
He's a legend. He's an icon.
Yeah, exactly. You know, he could.
And he's a champion right now.
Exactly. A good fighter. He has a lot of gas in the tank still. So I'm a big fan of Manny Pacquiao. And, anything can happen with Manny Pacquiao.
What's your best, most thing that impressed you the most 11 years ago, 10 years ago, 9 years ago when you watched Manny Pacquiao when he was coming up? What impressed you the most when you watched him?
Well, the way he is, you know, very humble and, you know, just the way that he works, man. I never seen nobody work as hard as he did when I was there. He was just non-stop, you know, non-stop. And a lot of rounds of sparring, a lot of heavy bags, a lot of exercises, and just focus on what he was doing, you know, and that's what made him a superstar.
I watched your son, Jose, was only 17 at the time, spar Manny, and it was epic sparring sessions. Tell us about that.
Man, it was very exciting. My heart was pumping, you know, because at that age, Junior was 17. I mean, sparring one of the best fighters pound for pound in history, you know. But, you know, these guys, you know, they took care of him. You know, they worked with him and showed him a lot. And I'm very appreciative and very thankful for Freddie Roach letting me train there at the gym, and Manny Pacquiao, you know, giving us the opportunity to even say that we sparred him, you know.
Yeah, no, that definitely that's... By the way, Kevin Newman, as you know Kevin, I'm sure,
yes,
from Vegas, he's been calling out Edgar Berlanga. What do you think about that fight?
You know, that's another good fight. Both of them are, I think, they're kind of like right there. But that would be a good fight for both of them. They need each other in order to keep advancing. I would like to see that fight. I think Berlanga's a pretty good, strong fighter. Kevin Newman also, you know, he's a good fighter. So, in my opinion, man, you know, like me, man, I'm maybe 50-50.
50-50, all right. That's a good fight. Berlanga just won Prospect of the Year. Congratulations to him.
And, yeah, congratulations. Young guy, you know, he's coming up, you know. And, you know, for some reason, he says that David's hating on him. I mean, I don't think we're hating on nobody, you know. He's a really good fighter. He's doing what he's supposed to be doing. Right now, he'll stop these fighters. But once he goes to the next level, the knockouts are not going to come in, because we all go through that. You know, once you start fighting gatekeepers and people that have a lot of experience, the knockouts are not going to come. You're not going to knock everybody out, bro. I tell you that right now. And, you know, hopefully he keeps learning and keep getting better. I see him being a world champion, you know. I think he has all the tools, but sometimes you just got to relax a little bit and be patient.
He's young, he's confident, he's doing everything right now, 16-0, 16 knockout the first round. But a fight with him and David, maybe in a year or two, will be a major fight.
Major fight, but right now I don't think he should even call those guys that he's ready to fight them, you know, like Canelo, David, and all the fighters right there, you know. I mean, we haven't showed anything yet, but we would love to fight them. You know, like I said, I also sent him a text to Instagram.
Did he respond?
Yeah, he did.
Did he say?
So I could talk to his manager because at that time we didn't have
an opponent
because they fell off, and I thought, hey, you know, he does have a good following.
He's popular. With Snoop and with Lil Wayne and
it would be a good fight.
Fat Joe.
You know, I talked to his manager, and, you know, his manager agreed that right now, you know, he needs a couple of fights. He would love to fight in the future with David, but I could only try, you know?
Hey, Robert. Robert. Jose Sr., Jose, reached out to Berlanga and his manager to set up a fight with Berlanga and David.
What? They're doing a good job with Berlanga, but he's got no chance against David.
Why do you say that? 16-0, 16 knockouts in the first round.
Okay.
Like I told him, we all go through that, you know, at one time.
Shut up, Elie. You've been in boxing for like 15 years. You should know some boxing already.
David, did you hear what he said? He said Berlanga has no chance against you. It would be a good fight. I'd love to see it.
He said I'm willing to fight anybody right now. It doesn't matter who it is. They have high KO percentage, no KO percentage. My job right now is as a fighter, it's to beat whoever.
That's true. And right now it's Ron Ellis on March 13. Showtime? Fox, Showtime. All right, make sure to tune in. Benavidez 300.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.